Dr. Nguyen?
Hi, sir. Doctor, we're just trying to learn a little bit more information. Sir, if you could just answer a couple questions for us, we'd really appreciate it if possible. Sir. Sir. I mean, we'd just really like to know, sir.
2018년 12월, 애리조나의 한 건강관리시설에서 29세의 여성이 건강한 아기를 출산했습니다. 하지만 그 아기의 출생은 보호자나 시설 관리인, 간호사 등 아무도 예상하지 못한 일이었죠. 그 아기를 출산한 어머니는 26년 동안 식물인간 상태였기 때문이었습니다. 이 충격적인 사건은 전 세계적으로 분노를 일으켰고, 사건이 일어난 지 5년이 지나서야 당시 현장의 사람들의 모습이 담긴 바디캠 영상이 공개되었습니다. 그럼 식물인간 상태의 여성이 어떻게 아무도 모르는 사이에 임신을 하고 출산까지 할 수 있었던 것일까요? 짐승과 다름없는 남성이 무방비 상태의 그녀를 성폭행하였던 것이었습니다. 2018년 12월 29일, 애리조나주의 피닉스의 사립요양시설인 하시엔다 헬스케어에서 환자가 출산을 시작하자 간호사들은 911에 신고 전화를 하게 됩니다.
Oh, the baby's turning blue. Baby's turning blue.
Okay, where are you at?
We need an RPD.
What is the address, ma'am?
Baby's turning blue. Baby's turning blue.
Ma'am, I need an address. I need an address.
I'm sorry.
Okay, and is that a house or an apartment?
No, it's a facility for.
Okay, I'm going to get paramedics are on the line. You need to give them the address again.
What's the emergency?
Someone just had a baby. One of our patients just had a baby, and we had no idea she was pregnant.
Okay, is the baby
out? We are not prepared for that. Baby's turning blue. We need someone now.
Okay, and the mom is doing okay?
We're not sure. We had no idea this patient was pregnant.
Well, God, what's going on right now?
Were we able to get the baby out? Is the baby breathing? Is the baby breathing? Baby's not breathing. Baby is blue.
Okay, so are they doing CPR?
Yeah, they're doing CPR on the baby.
Okay, good. Just keep going with that. And how's the mom doing?
Mom's doing well. It looks like she's doing well.
How far along
is she? Did we get a set of vitals? We had no idea this person was pregnant. We had no idea this patient was pregnant.
Okay, I understand. Does she know how far along she was or anything?
We have no idea. This is a complete surprise. We were not expecting this.
식물인간인 그 여성은 1992년부터 그곳에 있었습니다. 자그마치 26년 동안 말이죠. 입원할 당시 3살이었던 그녀는 어린 시절 거의 익사할 뻔한 경험을 한 후 잦은 발작을 일으켰고 그 뒤 지적, 신체적 연구장애가 오게 되었습니다. 운동 및 인지기능을 포함하여 팔과 다리의 기능을 잃었고 말도 할 수 없게 되었습니다. 그래서 그녀는 3살 때 하시엔다에 입원하여 대부분의 시간을 코마 상태로 보냈죠. 그녀는 머리와 목을 아주 조금은 움직일 수 있었고 자극에 대해 약간의 얼굴 표정도 만들 수 있었습니다. 하지만 심각한 지적장애로 누구와의 대화에서 어떤 이해도 할 수 없는 상황이었죠. 원초적인 반응만 할 수 있을 뿐이었습니다. 그래서 그녀의 인생 어떤 시기에도 성관계에 동의할 수 있었던 때는 없었죠. 그리고 12월 29일 아침, 일상적인 환자 체크 시간에 간호사들은 피해자의 침대 옆에 서 있을 때 끙끙 앓는 듯한 소리를 내는 그 여성을 마주하고 놀랄 수밖에 없었습니다. 이불을 걷어보니 아랫도리와 침대가 젖어 있었고 아기의 머리가 반쯤 나와 있었으니까요.
She had a baby. Look, there's a baby right there.
Okay. Are they trying to resuscitate the baby?
Are you guys still doing? Because they want you guys to still do compressions.
No,
the baby's breathing. Oh, the baby's breathing. Oh my God! Thank God.
Okay.
그 누구도 상상하지 못했기 때문에 이런 상황은 기쁨보다는 무섭게 다가왔습니다.
When I look, it wasn't really here. The baby came in.
Okay. Did anyone know she was pregnant?
I didn't know she was pregnant.
9.11 통화에서도 들었던 것처럼 직원들은 그녀가 임신을 하고 있었다는 사실을 전혀 몰랐다고 주장했습니다. 물론 배가 볼록하게 나와 있는 걸 조금 이상하게 느끼긴 했지만 변비나 체중 증가로 생각하고 그에 맞는 치료법을 진행했다고 했습니다. 관장을 하거나 식단의 칼로리를 줄이는 것으로 말이죠. 사실 그 누구나 똑같은 생각을 했을 것 같습니다. 그녀는 걷거나 대화를 하거나 성관계 동의를 하는 등의 행동은 일절 할 수 없는 상태였으니까요. 이 출산은 시설 전체에 큰 충격을 줬습니다. 5년 만에 공개된 바디캠 영상에서 보이는 많은 직원들은 충격에 울거나 떨고 있었죠. 이런 혼란스러운 상황에서 경찰은 누가 담당 의사인지, 담당 간호사는 누구인지, 수간호사는 누구인지, 교대 간호사는 누구인지와 같은 질문들을 하고 다니며 빠르게 용의자를 탐색하러 다닙니다. 하지만 가장 중요한 건 누가, 언제 그녀의 방에 접근할 수 있었냐는 것이었죠. 수간호사의 진술에 따르면 피해자가 이곳에 있던 수십 년 동안 여동생, 남동생, 어머니에게만 방문 허락을 해주었으며 그 시간은 항상 낮이었다고 했습니다.
Only allowed to have female caregivers.
Okay.
So I know mom, sister, and brother have been here to see her, but they see her out in the day room. I'm the UL. I'm in charge on okay. the weekend. So during the week, I only work Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Does she get male visitors other than family?
Does she ever go home?
That's Wendy doesn't question. Go home at all.
Okay.
She never goes home.
Who's her lead, like head lead nurse, I guess? Or is it just like a rotation?
Yeah, it's rotation.
그리고 집에 돌아간 적은 없었고 항상 침대나 휠체어에 있었으며 여간호사들만이 그녀를 돌봤다고 했습니다.
When I looked, it was really hard. The baby coming.
Okay. Did you guys? Did anyone know she was pregnant?
I didn't know she was pregnant.
Do you know how the visitations here work?
Honestly, no.
Honestly, no? Okay. And then does she have any male staff that work with her?
No.
Are there any male janitors, anyone that goes into the rooms unattended by themselves, as far as you know?
I don't think so, no.
Okay, and she just has a full female staff, usually.
Mm-hmm, yes.
Okay.
응급호출 직원들 중 남자 간호사는 두 명이 있었지만 그들은 다른 병동에서 근무하고 있었습니다. 환자가 있는 시설의 한쪽은 여성들만 입원해 있고 여성들만 근무하도록 엄격하게 관리되고 있었죠. 다만 남자 직원들은 자신의 환자를 다른 부서에 데려가는 동안만 그 병동 쪽에 있을 수가 있었습니다.
And she never goes home, as far as you know?
As far as I know, I've never seen her go home at all.
And then only one people that, as far as you know, the only people that are visitors is just family.
Yeah, mom, dad, mom, sister, and the brother.
Do we have all their info? Do they have like a sign-in log or a visitor?
The nurse just took it. Yeah, we have the sign-in log up in the front.
Mom, sister, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys have any male? Like, because I guess what we're trying to figure out is
yeah,
any
I understand.
Male
we
family
have
staff or anyone that has
male
access.
Male staff, but yeah. Wendy is only female care only.
Okay, so no males. No males ever go into her room, no. Allegedly. Okay.
And we only have two. One's PRN, and the other one only works certain hours, but we never have them on this side. There's a whole nother side on that side.
Okay. So is this only female, like female mm-hmm. staff area? So only females are allowed to, in a sense, work in this area with it too?
Well, the guys come through here because we have another side that go that way.
Okay.
But they're always with the, they have their patient.
그리고 피해자 여성의 선임 간호사의 진술에 따르면 모든 방문은 승인을 받아야 했고 서명까지 받아야 했다고 합니다.
Can we see where the other nurses went with her charts
yeah,
and stuff?
Up in front where we come
okay,
in.
Perfect. Do you mind staying with this one, Rosa?
So we have a sign-in log that everybody has to sign in when they come in.
Do you guys have any cameras in the facility like that point out into the like to the hallways?
So we're under construction. So in here, I know that there's not. I know they're in there just in case tools get stolen. Outside the facility, I can show you where they just recently put them up.
How do the visitation work here in the hospital? Do you know?
I know they come in and they sign. Every time anybody comes in, they come in and sign. And from my understanding, it's people that are approved, so family members and stuff like that.
Okay.
So there has to be an approval reference how they get visited?
Yeah.
Okay. Do we have all the logs
of
how they've been signing in?
Yeah, they should be signing in that book.
In that big book?
She knows more about it. She's in charge of it.
Do you know how far back those go?
No, that she would know. She would be the one to know.
Biggest thing we're trying to get right now, and I know they're working on getting it for me, just all of her medical records, primary care physician, nurses, visitor logs, tracking about probably 9 months back.
Okay.
So,
or if you don't have to write it down, if we can just show us where it is, we'll do it ourselves.
Okay.
Yeah, or if they can just even just make copies, even that'd be perfect. But mom, sister, brother are the ones that visit her. There's a sign-in roster for it. There's no cameras in the facility.
So you need visitor log. I'm sorry.
Visitor logs, primary care physician, primary nurse.
Is it the same staff?
No,
it's a rotating staff.
Okay.
So, because that's like today.
Are you staffing schedules? Are you looking for
any male staffing schedules? Okay. So, yeah, it's going 9 months back.
그럼 대체 누가 이 여성을 가족과 직원들 앞에서 성폭행하고 임신을 시킬 수 있었던 것일까요? 이 사건 이후 공식적인 성폭행 조사가 시작되었습니다. 피해자의 변호사인 존 마이클스는 출산 당일에 실시된 의학 검사에 따르면 피해자가 성폭행을 당한 건 처음이 아니었고 여러 차례의 성폭행을 겪었을 것으로 보인다고 주장했습니다. 메리 쿠퍼 카운티 메디컬 센터에서는 상처를 입었다가 치유된 지뢰 흉터가 발견되었고 이 흉터는 출산으로 인해 생긴 것이 아니었습니다. 게다가 더욱 충격적인 것은 과거에도 이미 임신을 한 적이 있었다는 것이었죠. 마이클스 변호사는 이게 그녀를 조사한 전문가의 소견이지만 최소한 물리적인 흉터를 봤을 때 반복적인 범행이 저질러졌음이 증명되었다고 주장하였죠. 경찰은 나중에 수색영장을 얻어 모든 남자 직원들을 상대로 DNA 샘플을 채취하였습니다. 그리고 그 DNA는 출생한 남자아이의 DNA와 대조 분석되었습니다. 그러자 충격적이게도 DNA가 일치하는 남성이 드러났고 그는 이곳에서 일하는 정식 간호사인 36세의 네이선 서덜랜드였습니다.
Did your guys' parents didn't want you to listen to rap? And why was the reason? What did she give you a reason?
No, I think it's mainly it was my dad, because we grew up like really, really strict and stuff, and there was no hip hop music. There was no, not even if it was gospel. Not even if it was gospel, man. But you know, can't stop what you were made to do.
그는 10년 이상의 경력을 가진 정식 간호사였고 그중 7년 동안 하시엔다 헬스케어에서 일했습니다. 유부남인 그는 4명의 자식이 있었고 애리조나주의 간호사 이사회에서도 아무런 범죄 이력이 없는 깨끗한 사람으로 인정하고 있었죠. 그 이사회의 기록에 따르면 2007년에 노숙자와 발달장애인을 돕기 위한 자선단체까지 만든 것으로 되어 있었습니다. 하지만 이 시점에 그는 식물인간 여성에게서 태어난 남자아이의 DNA와 일치하는 남성으로 밝혀졌죠. 그는 곧바로 체포되었고 하시엔다 헬스케어에서 곧바로 해고되었습니다. 그리고 간호사 라이센스를 포기하는 것에 동의하였죠.
Just to discover today who it was, it's just even more disturbing.
Cynthia Jones is a former Hacienda healthcare employee who remembers her once friend and colleague like this, a picture she gave us today.
He was always clean shaved. His hair was always nicely done. It's completely different than what I see on the picture today.
She says often, due to their job duties, she and Sutherland saw patients at the same time.
What was your experience like with him inside patients' rooms?
I was in and out, and he would stay in the room, you know, dealing with the patients.
By himself?
By himself. I mean, he was always just professional about everything.
And another inside source, exclusively giving Arizona's family Sutherland's last planning worksheet form, outlining his goals at the facility. Sutherland filled this out in July of 2018, writing his goal was to attend more AZ State Board of Nursing meetings and to continue leadership classes. He also wrote his short-term goal was to get an RN program going, and overall, he wanted to continue to evolve. He filled this out when his alleged victim was about 4 months pregnant. Jones says even though this is shocking, unfortunately, she says Jones' solo access to patients made it possible.
So, in your opinion, was he in patients' rooms long enough to where it would be feasible for him to do something like this?
Yeah. Yes.
2019년 2월 5일, 서덜랜드는 한 건의 성폭행 혐의, 한 건의 성인 학대 혐의로 기소 뒤 열린 재판에서 무죄를 주장했습니다. 당시에 그는 50만 달러의 보석금이 정해져 구금되어 있었죠.
Mr. Sutherland, may I have your full name, please?
Nathan Darcy Sutherland.
And your date of birth?
3/31/1982.
And counsel, do you intend to represent Mr. Sutherland through the process or just for today's hearing?
Through the process at this point, Your Honor.
All right, then the court will not appoint an attorney. Mr. Sutherland, you're here on one count sex assault, a class 2 felony, one count child or vulnerable adult abuse, a class 2 felony. The court is not appointing an attorney. Your next court date will be January 30th at 8:30 in the morning in the Superior Court downtown. I do have attorneys here that wish to be heard on release conditions. I'm going to start with the state and then turn to your attorney.
그의 변호사인 데이브 그레거는 검찰이 물적 증거를 확보하지 못했다며 무죄를 주장하였습니다. 검찰 측에서 주장하고 있는 DNA 증거도 원고 측에서만 진행한 것이지 자신들도 진행해보아야 한다며 재판을 연기시키기도 했죠. 이렇게 형사재판이 열리고 있던 중에 피해자의 가족은 애리조나주를 상대로 4,500만 달러의 소송을 제기했습니다. 그 이유는 식물인간인 딸아이가 주에서 인정한 의료시설에서 이런 일을 당했다는 이유 때문이었죠. 여기 일한 직원들은 하나같이 피해자가 임신하고 있다는 사실을 몰랐다고 주장했고 변비인 줄만 알았다며 그 치료는 계속해서 진행했다고 했으니까요. 피해자의 가족이 제출한 소장에는 직원들이 피해자의 임신을 확인할 수 있는 기회가 83번이 있었고 그 모든 기회를 놓친 거라고 적혀 있었습니다. 게다가 9개월 동안 생리를 하지 않았을 뿐만 아니라 간호사들의 증언에 따르면 총 24회나 아기가 발차기 하는 것을 보았고 주치의는 6개월에서 출산하기 전까지 10번이나 진찰했었다고 말이죠. 이건 말로도 표현하기 힘든 잔인한 행위들이 자행되는 동안 그 누구도 체계적인 관리를 하지도 아니면 아예 존재하지도 않았던 것이라고 했습니다. 피해자 가족은 2021년 6월에 결국 애리조나주 정부와 1,500만 달러의 합의금에 도달하였고 이외에도 750만 달러의 합의금을 받았습니다. 그리고 2019년 9월 2일 서덜랜드는 결국 자신의 유죄를 인정하였습니다.
Well, the judge heard testimonials from Sutherland's sister and mother-in-law, along with stories about his rough childhood, and more recently, time helping other inmates study the Bible. But in the end, she gave him 10 years in prison, minus more than 1,000 days of time served.
I didn't realize I was capable of such evil, disturbing act.
Nathan Sutherland hoped to gain sympathy from the judge. Born in Haiti, he says he was neglected by his mother, sexually assaulted at an orphanage, and that the bitterness and hatred led to depression and drugs as an adult.
Thus caused me to eventually to react inappropriately to my pain, torment, and therefore commit that evil act.
The 29-year-old victim in this case was in the Hacienda facility since 1992 after nearly drowning as a child. No one knew she was pregnant until she began giving birth to a baby boy. Her family did not speak in court or to the media outside. Sutherland, shackled in court, did speak for more than 10 minutes, but only briefly apologizing to the victim and her family.
To the victim, I'm sorry. You didn't deserve to be hurt. No matter what was going on in my personal life and the demons I was fighting, I had no rights to put you through that. No words can express how painfully sorry I am. I am sincerely sorry.
Sutherland will be on probation for life and will have to register as a sex offender. By the way, the child he fathered will be 3 years old later this month.
그는 최대 10년의 징역형, 평생 동안의 보호 관찰을 선고받았습니다. 그리고 피해자는 즉시 하시엔다 헬스케어에서 나와서 이젠 5살이 된 아이와 함께 주 정부에서 지원하는 의료 서비스를 받으며 가족과 잘 지내고 있습니다. 하시엔다 헬스케어는 이 사건이 발생된 후 CEO가 사임하고 이사회에 두 명의 멤버가 교체되었습니다. 이는 매우 끔찍하고 극도로 예민한 사건으로 많은 사람들의 주목을 받았지만 결과는 취약계층에 놓인 사람들의 치료가 더욱 체계적으로 이루어질 수 있는 계기가 되었습니다. 애리조나주가 요양시설의 관리 방식을 크게 바꾸는 데 일조하였죠. 그런데 피해자의 주치의는 그녀가 임신을 했고 출산할 예정이었다는 사실을 분명히 알 수밖에 없었을 겁니다. 그 주치의는 바로 탕 응우엔 박사였죠.
At the state medical board where they were scheduled to review whether Dr. Tan Nguyen should keep his medical license after an incapacitated woman in his medical care gave birth in late December.
She had a baby.
Records show caregivers missed 83 signs. The woman, unable to speak or move without assistance, was pregnant. Dr. Nguyen became the primary doctor in September of last year, and the medical board is now deciding the fate of his medical license. Today, though, the board removed his case from the agenda. Medical board executive director Pat McSorley declined an interview on camera, saying she could not comment on pending cases, but she said there are numerous reasons why a case could be pulled from the agenda. And told us that the board likes to be thorough and look at all information. But despite his case no longer being before the board, Dr. Nguyen was there, dressed in sunglasses, a fedora, a jacket, and a scarf. He noticed our cameras, and even after the board broke for lunch, stayed stock still, even as the room emptied out. We waited around 15 minutes before we approached the doctor to ask questions about what exactly happened at Hacienda Healthcare.
Dr. Nguyen? Hi, sir. Doctor, we're just trying to learn a little bit more information. Sir, if you could just answer a couple questions for us, we'd really appreciate it if possible. Sir. Sir. I mean, we'd just really like to know. Sir?
Now, he would actually continue running all the way outdoors, all the way to the parking garage. We actually found his cell phone and gave him a call later, and Dr. Nguyen still refused to answer our questions and hung up on us.
응우엔에 대한 심사는 계속해서 진행되었고, 결국 그는 파면됩니다.
Dr. Tan Nguyen officially out. Arizona's family obtained this letter from the Arizona Healthcare Cost Containment System Tuesday, known as ACCESS, informing Dr. Nguyen his contract with them as a provider was officially suspended on January 15th. The letter, signed by the Inspector General, was sent to Nguyen's home and to Hacienda Healthcare. The patients Dr. Nguyen saw at Hacienda all fall under ACCESS, including the victim in a vegetative state who was raped, then gave birth at the facility in December, with apparently no staff knowing she was pregnant. Several inside sources telling us Dr. Nguyen was the doctor in charge of her care. And in the letter, ACCESS states, based on their review, they determined the health or welfare of one or more of their ACCESS members is endangered by leaving their members in his care. Karina Cecina.
피해자의 신원은 아무래도 식물인간이라는 특수한 상태와 보호자들이 원치 않았기에 사회에 공개되지 않았습니다. 하지만 여러분이 주목해야 할 점은 이런 파렴치한 범죄가 현대사회에서도 발생하고 있다는 것이고 그것에 대한 정의도 어느 정도 잘 이루어지고 있다는 것입니다. 어느 정도 잘 이루어진다고 말씀드린 건 가해자인 네이선의 형량이 너무 가볍다고 생각이 들어서죠. 고작 10년형의 평생 보호 관찰이라니 할 말이 없습니다. 오늘 사건 이야기는 여기서 마치겠습니다. 식물인간 상태의 여성을 잔인하게 성폭행하고 출산까지 하게 만든 악마이자 기만자인 네이선 서덜랜드 사건. 흥미롭게 보셨다면 좋아요와 구독을 눌러주시면 좋겠군요. 저는 쇼킹TV 톰슨이었습니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다.